let us understand, if you are a shopkeeper and you have to write your name, I'm a Ram Patil, so my name is there, my business name, RP Traders. By name you can see, I'm not a manufacturer, I'm not a service provider. What is nature of my business? Trading activity. Trading activity means buy goods, sell goods, okay? So here we are taking different situation, and I'm saying that I'm challenging which system? VAT. See, we challenge all three system, and everybody like that VAT system. VAT is the best system, no cascading effect. Now I'm trying to prove that there is a still cascading effect, and that's why GST. Okay? So, sir, what will happen as a trader? What will happen? First thing that you should buy for a trader is your input. Right, and your input is equal to raw material or finished goods, beta? Finish. You are buying finished goods because you are a trader, no? You are just a trader. You are buying finished goods and selling finished goods. So your input is finished goods. Am I clear? Now let us discuss what kind of taxes 1% pay on finished goods. Now this is a finished goods. When it was manufactured, you paid excise duty. You paid because excise duty is also required from buyer. You paid excise duty, all right? The moment this goods was sold, you paid VAT. You paid VAT. The moment this goods enter in your Maharashtra territory or Mumbai territory, you paid octroi or LBT. You paid LBT, local body tax, octroi, entry tax, purchase tax, so many names are given, okay? Out of these three, you tell me you will get credit only of one item. VAT. Why VAT, sir? Because VAT, we have just seen, no? If you pay VAT, you will get credit of VAT. Achha, by the way, if you paid VAT, that means there is a trader sitting here. Manufacturer. That manufacturer will pay this VAT to which government? You both are in same state. Better I write intrastate input. What is intrastate input? You are purchasing from state, same state. That means the whatever VAT you paid here, this VAT you paid to which government? State government. Which state government? Maharashtra. Alright. Now what will you do? You will keep this stock at your storeroom. This is your stock. Yeah. After some days, some person will come to buy this stock. Yeah. That is your output. Intrastate output or interstate output? Intrastate output. Output means in technical language, sale. Let's not make it more complicated. But when you sell, which tax you will add here, beta? Output VAT. You will add output value added tax. On invoice, we have just seen it. But you will not pay output VAT to Government of India. You will obviously book input tax credit minus input tax credit, but of which tax? Only VAT. Okay, and then there will be your net liability. You will have net liability. All right, matter ends here. This much understanding everybody is having in this classroom. Point one. Okay, let's write points here. Here, demerits of VAT system. Demerits of VAT system or input tax credit system. No ITC on excise duty and entry tax or local body tax or purchase tax. So it is not available. Alright? Excise duty is available as a credit, but that credit is called as sen VAT credit. Excise duty is a sen VAT. Sen VAT credit is available only to manufacturer and service provider. Why? Because excise duty is payable to which government, beta? Central government. What is the logic? If you pay to central government, how can you ask credit from state government? If you want credit of sen VAT, you should ask it from which government? But this guy being a trader, he is not registered in any central act. Sir, he is not registered under Manufacturing Act, that is Excise Act. Why? He is not manufacturing. Sir, service tax was also on central level. But is it a service provider?
No.
That's why he is neither registered in excise duty, neither registered in service tax. That means he is not registered under any act. That's why SINVAT cannot be claimed by trader. Excise duty is available as a SINVAT, but SINVAT is not available to trader because trader is not registered under any central law. Hi. See, I'm challenging current system now, so it is quite difficult. I wanted to teach only this much, but new student will not understand why are we doing this. So are you clear with this at least, that VAT is available as a credit? What about this? Very carefully. Interstate input. Whenever you buy interstate goods, that means from your state or another state. So you went to Gujarat. From Gujarat you purchase goods. You are bringing that goods to India. Sale has happened in which state? Input. You purchase goods from Gujarat. From your angle, that input, okay, for this input, sale has happened in which state?
Gujarat.
Okay. If there is a sales tax levy, which government will charge sales tax? Can they charge Gujarat VAT on this? No. Gujarat VAT can be charged only if that happens in Gujarat state. Like we are charging Maharashtra value added tax on our state. Whenever there are two states involved, what central government will do? Maharashtra government, you set aside. Gujarat government, you chop. Okay. I'll levy one act, and that act was CST, Central Sales Tax, 92A, entry number 92A, Constitution of India, yesterday we discussed. That means person here will not pay VAT. He will not pay VAT. He'll again pay excise duty. Because excise duty is applicable, to whole India. He will also pay, CST. Right? He will also pay entry tax, local tax. So I'm talking like writing local body taxes, different taxes. Okay? But the problem is that CST credit cannot be taken here. Why? CST credit. Excise is not available. That is clear now. But even CST is also sales tax.
Yes.
VAT is also sales tax. But CST credit you cannot take against VAT. Why? Because you paid CST to Gujarat government. Problem is that. See, central sales tax should be paid to? But central government doesn't have a department. No, yesterday I told you that logic. That it was supposed to be paid to central government. But what Gujarat government were saying? See, we will charge CST. You will take CST from us. And what will it, as a central government, what will we do with the CST? Again allocate to states. So why don't we keep it? Right? It will save all transaction of this money flow. So it was launched, charged by central government, but collected and retained by state government. State government was only responsible for collection, but smartly they were keeping it with them. Now you tell me why CST credit is not given by Maharashtra government. Why they are resisting to give credit? First of all, you did not pay this amount to, VAT you paid to Maharashtra. But CST you paid to which government? And how can you ask tax paid to Gujarat government and set off from Maharashtra government? Beta, that's why one more problem in existing system. Trader was having credit ITC, no ITC on interstate purchases, that is CST. And let me tell you, CST Act doesn't have any provision of set off. CST Act doesn't have any provision of set off. Okay, that means if I purchase goods from Maharashtra, I had paid CST. I said sold these goods to Karnataka, I will be liable to pay CST payable, CST paid. Set off, See, this is not possible because VAT payable, CST credit. This setup is obviously not possible. But what I am trying to say, CST इतना गिरा हुआ है, VAT के सामने तो set off होगा ही नहीं, खुद के सामने भी नहीं होता. Obviously, logic is what? CST you pay to Gujarat government and again CST you will pay to Maharashtra government. Because now Maharashtra is selling state. Okay. Second thing is CST Act doesn't have any concept of safe. Even if I purchase goods from Gujarat, I pay CST. I am selling goods to Gujarat. I am liable to pay CST, but to different government. Maharashtra. Selling state charge CST because CST is a sales tax, not purchase tax. I know you are quite feeling heavy, but this is how it goes. GST is a change today. That means these people were finding these problems over the period of time. They identify these kind of problems and then they propose a GST in parliament. This is how minister must have thought about. Okay, that this is the problem, this is the problem. As a trader, they are facing this kind of problem. One more problem. Are you clear with these three problems? Gradually, you will understand. You have to understand. You have to read it again and again and then you will understand. Okay, now we are doing for trader. Again, we will do it for manufacturer and then we will do it for service provider. For three times, from three different angles, I am going to teach these problems. Okay, now next one. As a trader, don't you think that trader also takes some services? He takes some services or does not take any services? Obviously, he takes some services. I must call them input services. Why? He is not providing services, but he takes services. So, what kind of services one trader can take? Give me examples. Transportation, banking, insurance, telecommunication, internet, chartered accountant, company secretary if this is a very big company. Trader means Big Bazaar is also trader. Huh? Do not consider trader means Baniya ka shop. Trader means traders. Yaar. Even Hindustan Unilever is a trader. Right? So there are big listed companies who are making crores of rupees as a turnover. So trader can have this kind of input services. Right? Many types of services. And whenever you had taken services in India, you pay service tax. And on service tax itself, you pay Swachh Bharat SES, Krishi Kalyan SES, many SES were there. So service tax, overall service tax. Can this guy get credit of service tax? Because service tax credit was available as a SENVAT. Can he claim SENVAT? No. Why? Because he is not registered under service tax. Why he is not registered under service tax? Because he is not providing. Are but beta, he paid so many taxes. Credit is available only for VAT. You know what happens today? Post, this is pre-GST. No ITC on. Service tax, Swachh Bharat SES or Krishi Kalyan SES. What happens post-GST? What happens post GST? Nalayaks. Excise duty is gone. Now GST. VAT is gone. GST. LBT is gone. GST. Excise duty gone. GST. CST gone. GST. LBT gone. GST. Service tax gone. GST. Swachh Bharat Krishi Kalyan gone. GST. Now he'll pay GST. He'll be payable GST. He paid GST. Payable GST. GST payable minus GST paid. Now he'll get credit of everything. Which system is better now?
GST.
I just wanted to say that. Whatever GST he paid, he'll get credit. One statement they had written in your book. To explain one statement, you will get credit of GST paid. This is the crux. You will get credit of GST paid. And where can I use that credit, sir? Whenever there is a GST payable. Sir, but I don't pay GST. Now you have to pay, everybody has to pay GST only. Sir, service provider, pay GST. Because goods and?
Services.
Sir, manufacturer pays GST. Sir, trader also pays?
GST.
That means now everybody is paying same tax.
Yes.
And everybody is liable to pay same tax.
Yes.
That means everybody is enjoying
credit.
Credit now. That's why trading sector is very happy with the GST. But one trading part is very worried, like they are worried about it, retailers. Because they were hidden. Many retailers in India were hidden. They were not paying taxes, although they were supposed to pay taxes. Now they are exposed. How? If I sell my goods to trader, that transaction is called as B2B transaction. And B2C means business to consumer. In B2B transaction, I'll put trader's name in my return, his PAN number. I had to mention that data. That means he now knows that, government knows that he purchased the goods. See, as a consumer, you will purchase one marker. As a trader, he'll purchase 1,000 marker. Now, we don't use 1,000 marker on board. See, we are consumer for marker. But person who had purchased this stationery shop, he is not a consumer, he is a customer, he is a dealer, he purchased and he will sell.
Yes.
But he was not registered under VAT. Now he has to get registration under GST. Because government knows that he purchased goods. So he is worried now that he purchased, that means he will sell. This is how that trader level, last level. See, manufacturer were registered, wholesaler big player registered, distributor big player. Who was not registered in existing system? Only dealers. Now concept of ghost dealer is also gone. Acha, GST is multi point tax or single point tax? That means everybody has to pay tax. Understood? Clear? So GST is a VAT, but better than VAT. Okay, because of this, please write down. AC बंद करना।